The Canucks, they finally beat the San Jose Sharks. Final score 4-2, snapping an 11-game winless drought against the Sharks. I know you hate that, Gary, because it includes preseason.
Yes, I do.
Mike Santarelli
that.
Snaps a 12-game goalless drought. He's with Murph.
Canucks win in San Jose. It was a lengthy streak against San Jose. The Canucks hadn't won, but Mike, you're only here for the first two this season. Since those two games took place basically in the first week of your season, what did you guys learn from those games and what did you do better this evening?
Yeah, you know what? They're a great team over there. They're a fast team. They transition well, and they have a lot of offense over there. So, you know, tonight I thought we played with speed as well and got pucks in deep and got pucks to the net, and that's what we got to do to be successful.
A few games now with your line intact with Burrows and Higgins. What have you liked about that trio?
Oh, like those two are amazing players. You know, Burr has a nose for the net and makes great plays, and same with Higgy. Higgy's strong on the pucks, and you know, he finds the net too. So those guys are two great players and fortunate to play with them.
Some weird goals this year. What did you think of that, the first one in tonight?
Oh, the first one was a little tough. I mean, bad bounce off the end board there, lively boards, but, you know, it was good for us to, you know, come back and not let that affect us.
Finally, this road trip, if you look at it, is probably the toughest road trip of the season for any team so far, these four Pacific Division teams. Did you feel like you guys played better this evening than you did in Phoenix?
Yeah, I thought we came out stronger. We were maybe a little sluggish in the first game there against Phoenix, but we you know, responded well. Tonight, I thought we played like a full 60, and we need to do that moving forward. They're such great teams.
Santarelli with his fifth of the season. The Canucks defeat the Sharks 4-2.
All right, Murph, thanks so much. Yes, 4-2 for the Canucks over San Jose. Here to talk about it, as always, ex-Canuck turned analyst Gary Volk. And you look at the way this game started, and yet the Canucks were able to bounce back from that. First of all, have you seen a goal like that?
The first goal, I haven't seen one in a while. We've seen a bunch of weird ones this year, and this is right amongst the weirdest of them all. And a lot of times, yeah, you can blame this one on the net being a little bit narrower. They took those 4 inches away. If that was last year, that puck sits on the net. This year, it's in the net, and Luongo. That's the first shot on net. Again,
sixth time
this year the opposition has scored with the first shot on net. And then Luongo settled in. He let only two goals in on the night, and he made a number of huge stops when the Canucks were up 4-2. Look, you knew San Jose was going to make a push. You knew they were. He came up big when he needed, but the Canuck defense today were unbelievable. They were right where they had to be, right when San Jose made the push, especially on their power plays. On the San Jose power plays, which, by the way, they haven't scored yet on the Canucks on their power play, San Jose. The Canucks PK was good, but their defense was real solid in this game.
13 saves in the third period for Roberto Luongo. You like the way, meanwhile, that Ryan Stanton played.
Well, we don't talk a lot about Ryan Stanton. I mean, Danny Hamus is playing well.
Of course, doesn't mind that.
Edler, and yeah, he doesn't mind that. But Ryan Stanton's a physical guy. He's got a ton of penalty minutes everywhere in Moose Jaw and Rockford where he played. When are you going to fight Ryan? Sure enough, he shows up in this. It takes these young guys a long time to get comfortable. When you see Ryan standing up, suddenly he's like standing up for teammates. He's getting involved that way. He got another assist in this game. He's tied for the rookie lead for assists amongst rookie defensemen in the NHL. He's got 7 points on the year. Do we expect him to be offensive? No, not really. But he's definitely been a surprise for Vancouver. And the 7 points you can't ignore.
All right. Also, Mike Santarelli breaks a 12-game goalless drought. But you wanted to make a point about the fact, his ice time hadn't dwindled at all.
Well, he kept getting the ice time, Donnie, and that just goes to show you just how much more he does than score goals, for sure. But nice to see him get, you can see the relief. Anytime you get over 10 games and you haven't scored, you start changing your stick tape. You start changing the laces on your skates. You start overthinking it, so it's real nice to see him get on the score sheet, but he does it all. Wins face-offs like he always does. Kills great penalties. Is in the right places. Look, we've said it before. There's a reason why Ryan Kessler's still on that number one line. It's because you got Mike Santarelli on that number two line, playing out of his mind this year so far for Vancouver.
All right. I'm going to test you right now. What's the key in L.A. on Saturday?
Yeah. The key in L.A. Saturday. Yeah. Getting quicks.
Get off to a quick start.
No, get in Jonathan Quick's kitchen.
Okay.
Get in his face. Get in front of the net. Score more goals like Zach Kassian got in this game.
Okay. Get off to a quick start.
Canucks, by the way, at 22 forced 22 San Jose giveaways in this game. Great forecheck.
Gary Volk, like NHL Nets, 4 inches shorter than last year.
Size does matter.
4-2 Canucks over San Jose. It is Gary Volk on a Thursday night.